our panelists. Our panelists, our first panelist is Mr. Vivek Madhukar, the CEO of Times Business Solutions. Mr. Vivek, can you please come to the stage? A warm welcome. We have with us also Mr. Sundar Ramachandran, the head of sales training for Pfizer. Mr. Sundar, can you please come on stage? And we have with us Mr. Ashu Malhotra, the HR head for Jabong.com. Mr. Ashu, can you please come on stage? So please, let's put our hands together and welcome our panelists. Over to you, Siddharth.
Hi all. Thanks for coming into this session. I know you're running a little late, so I'll try to do this faster. My name is Siddharth Banerjee. I head this company called Indusgeeks. We create game-based learning content and gamification platforms. And the process today is to essentially explain and get across what gamification means and what does game-based learning mean. And hopefully at the end of this panel discussion, you'll have a better understanding of both and how they can be practically applied to everyday enterprise requirements, processes, needs, and training. So without further ado, let me begin. So this is, you know, we're starting with the basic definitions of work, but we don't want to get into theory grasping. We'll try instead to see if we can make it more contextual. So since morning, I've been hearing a lot about how we are a millennial-driven economy, how our workforce, the Indian workforce, in fact, the workforce world over, in most countries especially, is being driven by millennials. But the big question is, how do these millennials engage with content? So if we leave aside gamification and game-based learning for a second, because they sound like exotic terms, so let's put that aside. What is actually going to captivate this millennial group's attention? You know, they are always on the phone, you're talking about that. There's always media that's available for them. So why should training be interesting? Training is boring to begin with. And it's been presented in a format which is even more boring, if it's possible. So how do you make training and learning more interesting? How does the communication become more interesting? And in that context, we're talking about games. I think everyone has seen kids at home play on consoles or on their cell phones. And the word rapture comes to mind, right? They're really in a state of rapture. But you never see that when you see a learning program. You don't see trainees sitting in rapture. When they are looking at, I mean, quite the contrary. So how do we bring that about? And so games and gamification is a process of increasing engagement to the point of what we call flow, right? We all know the term, when somebody is in flow. So game mechanics are used and game-based training is used to induce flow. Hence, higher cognitive functions kick in. Whatever they are learning, they are a lot more engaged with. The efficacy of the original training program actually goes up and the training outcomes improve. That is what lies at the core of the jargon of gamification and game-based training. How do you make training and learning outcomes more successful by actually implementing more interactive courses? So game-based learning is all about the process of actually creating a game or a simulation or a serious game that mimics your training outcomes and create actual content around it. It'll augment your didactic learning. It's immersive, it's engaging. Gamification, on the other hand, is just the application of gaming mechanics to any non-gaming context. Let me give you an example. For instance, if I had to create a training program to get you to come to this room in this hotel, I would have to create a replica of this hotel, put it up in a training program so you could do a virtual walkthrough and come here. That would be simulation-based training or game-based training where I actually created content. However, I know we're really running late on this session, everybody's hungry. And so if I said, well, if you stayed late enough and heard me out, there's a free drink. That's gamification. That's just inducing a game mechanic to give you incentive to have your participation and reward that participation. So that's pretty much the basic definitions of game-based learning and gamification. Gamification is used to spur behavioral change. It can't be used to solve complex problems. problem solving, cognitive thinking is triggered by actually creating content that does that. That's game-based learning. Moving on. So this was an example of something that we've done for SHRM. I'm going to skip over the video because we're running short of time. So we are at a SHRM conference, so I thought the context would make sense. So this is a good example of how to use game-based learning as well as gamification content to deliver a message. So SHRM approached us a couple of years back when they came to India, and they said, hey, you know what? We are new to the Indian market, and we want the Indian youth, the people who are just passing out of college and just getting into business schools or just passing out of business schools, to understand why HR as a process is really important to an organization. More importantly, also, why SHRM is contextual to that HR learning and HR process. So what we did was we came up with this concept of this guy called the office guy. His name was Kay, and the video was behind, but I'm not showing you that. And we came up with this series of games, which is actually the corporate world seen from the perspective of a 22-year-old kid who's just entering the workforce. So he's the protagonist, and the world evolves from this 22-year-old's perspective. He's here, he's picking up emails, he doesn't understand why he's being asked to do something. Somebody's saying, get off your phone, don't be on your phone all the time, because it's an HR policy. Well, what does that mean? You know, why is that contextual to a millennial? So we created a series of these games which would connect to the message of why is it important to have HR as a part of your organization. And through the meaning of the games and understanding and playing the games, they understand, hopefully, an evolved understanding of why HR is an important function. We put together one particular game, the one that you're seeing at the end, called Human Assembly. And what you had to do is you had to put together a team very quickly in a very short amount of time. And the reason we did this is we got a lot of feedback from younger generation folks, and they say, we are dehumanized. When we are asking somebody to put together a team, I'm a Java resource, or I'm a Flash resource, I'm a .NET resource, I'm not a human being. So we started sort of figuring out and creating a process where we essentially created a game where we asked these young kids to play a game and then asked them to remember the names of the people, and they couldn't. So they started understanding the challenges of what it means to be a senior level manager. We also gamified this content by running contests on Facebook and Twitter on the side, which we saw getting a lot of good responses. I'm going to pick this up because we're running a little short on time. So, that was a pretty exotic example, but how about a core process like sales? Can you do sales training through simulation and game-based training and gamification? The answer is you can. So one of our, for a very large insurance client in India, they had a particular challenge where they had to train 40,000 agents of all different demographics, housewives, retired folks, young folks, and also their own agent development managers in sales as well as recruitment training. So they approached us, and we've created a full-fledged, highly immersive simulation game-based learning program for them, where they essentially play as one of the protagonists on screen, and they have to walk through using their actual cognitive skills. And we've created deep diving, real-life encounters where they can actually go talk, negotiate, come up with convincing answers. And as they do that, they keep getting feedback which will reinforce their actual behavior. And you get real-time feedback and analytics, because any kind of learning program without concrete analytics to back it up would be useless. It's not for fun. I would like to repeat that. Game and gamification, fun is a part of it. Flow is the most important part of it. Engagement is the most important part of it. And you need to be able to measure that, and the training and the learning outcome, because without measurement, it wouldn't work. So you do get real-time feedback and analytics. And then, of course, you get enhanced decision-making skills, because this is another thing that I like to explain to people, is that in a simulation, in a game, you can actually show consequences of your action. You can't do that in real life. Even if I took you in a trainer-led class and did an instructor-led training, how do you show consequences? I did something, how do I fast forward time? 3 days, 1 month, 2 months later to show the impact of my decision at a scale in time. You can do that in an interactive game. So, and you get a very detailed feedback of your critical skills, of your trends across modules. And this is a number that I was harping about. Early tests show 91% people were highly engaged, and 87% of the people said they would do it again. We're talking about training content, not a movie. They said they would do it again. And you know, the results were really awe-inspiring. And you know, we've got a whole plethora of this. This was for insurance. We're working with Santander in UK. We're working with Department of Defense in the US. Healthcare, pharma, across all different industries, we are seeing the same result. Millennials want engaging learning, not boring computer-based, web-based training. And a part of what we are doing is to take that content and transform it into something engaging. With that said, I'm going to hand over the mic to Sundar, who's going to talk and present a use case on gamification, just like I did on game-based.
Hi, good afternoon. Just picking up